Hey YouTubers, Grimmy Dragon here, and this is the review for the Voltron Legendary Defender, Legendary Lions, and their combined Voltron form. Now, originally I was planning to do these guys individually, but I realized I'd be saying the same exact thing about all four of the Limb Lions, so I figured let's get this all done at once and look at them like that. Looking over these new lions, one will notice right away they look a lot closer to real cats than any of the previous incarnations. The streamlined body sculpts are more rounded than the blocky originals, at least on the red and green lions. Blue and yellow retain more of that angular feel, but there's still added curvature compared to the original lions. Even with this new take on the classic team, I can still find traces of almost all previous versions within them. The nods to Go Lion are fairly obvious, but there are hints of Voltron Force woven within the lions. Best example would be the yellow lion's underbite, which was originally featured in Voltron Force. There are plenty of hidden details molded in as well, like the ladders in each of the lion's mouths. I also love the fact that the lions have real digit grade feet. Just bending the knee back really didn't work for the previous versions, and I'm glad Playmates put the effort in with the back legs on these guys. Paint seems to be hit and miss here. For the most part, the paint is okay until you look at the yellow lion. I don't know why, but it looks like yellow got the worst luck of the group. The white paint on its maw is kind of globby, and the yellow on the paws is thin and doesn't match the rest of the toy as a result, and the red seems splotchy in areas. The other lions have cleaner paint apps, but still have the occasional blemish here and there, and would it really have killed them to paint the back of the black lion's waist silver to match the front? Honestly, that's kind of aggravating. Each of the four limb lions have a back-mounted missile launcher attached by a peg on the armbots or a clip on the legbots. The red and green lions' launchers have a rotation joint for more aiming poses, while yellow's fires out discs instead of the standard missile. The green lion also has a shield that can be mounted on one or two places, the back or the rear. This is more for the combined mode, as is the two halves of the sword included with red and green. Last but not least, each of the five lions include a tiny little sled to showcase the scale of these massive lions, and the sleds can be hidden in a compartment on the respective lion. So articulation-wise, the lions are mostly the same. At least the limb lions are mostly the same. So on like the arm lions, the green and red, you got ratchet joints at the shoulder, at the elbow, at the paw, and yeah, the paws are a little bit of a softer plastic, so they got a bit of bend, but they also got a good grip on the ground, so they're going to be pretty good for posing. But in the back, you got the ratcheted hips, ratcheted knees, and those are nice clicks too. Well, ratcheted ankle, and I guess a ratcheted a detented toe. Again, softer plastic. You don't hear the clicks, but you can feel them as you move. So that's pretty good. And nice to have some ratchet joints. You also have waist bend. That's more for the combined mode, and you have a ratchet at the head that turns left and right. And yeah, if you got those like cannons on there, they do rotate left and right as well, which is pretty cool. Well, pretty cool. So yeah, the leg lions, the yellow and blue, they don't have anything at the head really. Oh yeah, they do have jaws that open but snap shut. Same on the green and red. There is a little wiggle left and right, but not a whole lot. But you do got the usual, like, not as loud, but you do have that detented shoulder. And yeah, the elbows and paws both have their ratchets. Hips. Knee, just not quite as clicky, but you can feel it. And then you got the ankle and toe. So pretty good. Now the Yellow Lion's accessory is a little different than the others. That while they have firing missiles on the others, you get this disc launcher. And as you can tell, it fires pretty well, which is pretty cool. I like that. Works for me. And now we're going to get into the Black Lion and his articulation. Now he has up and down movement at the head, but no left and right, no swivel, which is a shame. You got some forward back at the shoulder. Kind of stops right at this point, so you can't go any further forward, which not sure why, but yeah, that's how far it goes. Got detents at the elbow, nice clicky paws. Back can go back and forward up to that far. Knee bend, nice and clicky. Ankle and toe, all very clicky, very sturdy. And you know, that's good because this is the main body and the, well, no pun intended, but the lion's share of the articulation is in the Black Lion. So yeah, he's going to have all the joints. You also got swivels at the wing. They can turn in and out. They go out that far. Nothing here, which is a shame, but still works. It's still a good arm or wing. I'm glad that it's there. And let's get into something else this can do. Turn the switch on the back and then push the button on the side, and then you get sound effects.
Voltron is the only thing that can stop Zarkon. Let's assemble Voltron and get rid of these Golra. Form Voltron! We need to increase firepower. Systems compromised. Destroy you. Now we go on the offensive. Let's light this thing up. Fire lasers! We will save the universe! Let's light this thing up. Fire lasers! Now we go on the offensive.
Yeah, and a lot of sound effects there, which is pretty cool. I like that. And there are more when you actually start forming Voltron, which makes the whole transformation an experience. And that's the key of this. The transformation, the combination, is an experience unto itself. And normally I would stop motion that combination, but, you know, since we got that experience factor, we're going to do this live. So I got red and blue already transformed, and I'll show you how to transform the green and yellow, since they work pretty much the same as red and blue. So, oh, yeah, that fires, so. But, yeah, you pull off that. And then, this is a cool trick. Might want to take the shield off for this part, but yeah, the arms actually tuck into the main body. Can be a little tricky. It is possible for these to get stuck. My Red Lion, the shoulder gets stuck all the time when trying to push it in, so be warned about that. Once they're in, closes up. The legs fold in. They fold in that far, but it helps to have them out this far. And then you pull out this post here, which will help, which is what's used to connect it to the Black Lion. Last but not least, push the tail in. It'll actually stop at the tip. And you got an arm done. Oh yeah, also put the shield back on. For the leg, we'll start by taking off that thing. And then this one, start by moving the shield back. So, got that. Push the head in and push it up. Push the, fold up the feet. They don't go into the main body, but they actually form the heels. So that's pretty cool. Again, fold in the back legs just like that. And then push the tail in. This one can be a little tricky since it's a little longer and it's got to snake its way into the main body, which can be difficult. Tails don't always want to go in right. So, yeah. There we go. And there's a leg. And on to the main body itself. Just flip off the switch just to make sure we get this done well. Move that up. And this guy gets big, so we're going to back up the camera just a bit. So first up, fold in legs, front legs. Flip on the covers, just like the vintage, which is pretty cool. Just straightened out the legs. Like so. And we'll flip down the head. And yes, the jaw does open. It stays open on Voltron himself. And there's a flip out face. And we just flip out the horns. And we have the main body ready to go. And yeah, the main body itself is actually almost at the top of the frame, and it's going to get a lot taller, so backing him up just a little more and hoping this works. Because he's a big one. He is a really big one. Okay, so turn it back on, because I'll flip these around. Yeah, that's going to happen a lot. So, let's get this experience started by putting a boot on. So, once you slide it in, provided you got it in right. Okay, never gave me problems before. Okay, that didn't go well.
Great work, team!
As you can see, as you detach, it actually makes a noise.
Whatever you say, hero!
There you go. You get noises every time you connect. And there are more than one. Not going to go into all of them, but every time you connect a lion... Seems to think that it's disconnected, but it's there.
We need the red lion!
As you can see, it knows what lions are missing, and it will ask for them. Just want to make sure he's in frame. So, yeah, it wanted the red lion. And now we got, last but not least, the green lion. And here we go.
Blue lion, ready for action. Red lion, ready for battle.
Green lion, all systems go.
Yellow lion engaged. Red, green, black, blue, and yellow lions detected. Voltron, operational. Voltron complete. Targeting Rope Beast.
And that's pretty cool. Like, they know when it's complete, and I like that. And you get some new sounds because they're combined.
Pitch! Form shield!
My shield can't take much more of this!
We need to increase firepower!
We got you, buddy!
Let's light this thing up! Fire lasers! Now we go on the offensive! Time to armor up! Lance, Hawk, give me full reverse thrusters.
Roger. Engaging lower thrusters.
Pitch, form shield.
Roger that.
Let's do it. Keep, form sword.
Time to heat things up.
Yeah, there is a lot of sound effects in this guy. And that's pretty cool. This is going to be one that people will have fun with. And it's a really good looking transformer. Well, okay, it's not really a transformer, but you get what I mean. It's a good combiner. It tops any Megazord. So, yeah. So let's get articulation. Nothing at the head. Horrible mistake on Playmates' part. This head should swivel. There should be a... There's plenty of room to put a swivel in there. And that's the only downside for it. Articulation, you got forward, backward at the shoulders.
Blue lion, ready for action. Red lion.
Oh, I turned that off. Okay, forward, backward at the shoulders. In and out. Bicep swivel. Elbow bend. The shield does get in the way a little bit, but... You know, that's on that arm. Wrist rotation. Nothing at the waist. Unfortunate, but, you know, I can understand that one. But you got... Forward, backward, at the hips. Nice heavy ratchet. A little bit outward. Not too far. Nice knee bend. Practically a double joint, thanks to the... way the digit grade works. You got a thigh swivel And the ankles do pivot just a little bit. And yeah, you can use the back legs of the blue and, well, the front legs of the blue and yellow lion to adjust for support, which is always good. If I had a complaint about the look of it, it'd just be that the head, the blue and yellow lion heads are too sunken in. They don't really feel like they're making feet. He feels kind of hooved. Other than that, really cool look. And yeah, that's your articulation, your combination, and everything else. Oh yeah, you can flip the wings up like this if you want. Oh, would help if you got a little taller. Again, this is a big boy. And yeah, you can get that more classic Voltron feel like that if you want. Thanks to Shuriken Shinobi for showing that off. But yeah, that's the combination in a nutshell. A long nutshell, but a nutshell. Voltron himself is quite a sight to behold. At 16 inches tall, he towers over many a Transformers Combiner or Power Rangers Megazord. He is slightly shorter than Combiner Wars Devastator, but big enough to be a worthy foe for the Green Giant. The look is almost perfectly in sync with the show model, save for the Black Lion shoulders, which, taking a cue from Panache Place's Voltron, are now Voltron shoulders and shoulder joints. If there is a flaw or two in the design, that would be the most noticeable, but not the most offensive. That dubious honor goes to the fact that there is no neck joint. Given how the neck was constructed, I fail to see how a swivel could not have been implemented. Even with that, Voltron can pose like a champ, thanks to all the lovely joints that Black Lion, along with Red and Green, have to offer. The rubbery paws on Blue and Yellow provide the feet with wonderful grip to the ground, helping him stay far more stable in static and dynamic poses alike. His sword is nowhere near as interesting as the Blazing Sword of old was, but it's serviceable. In the end, this new set of lions is a welcome addition to any Voltron fan's collection. Each lion can be fun to pose and play with on their own, and together they form a big bruiser of a bot that can plow through the competition with ease. It may not be the perfect Voltron, but it is a great rendition of him all the same. So, until next time, dear friends, goodbye out there. Whatever you are.